Hi, Kamal. Welcome to our show.
Nice to be on the show.
Thank you so much for being here.
I truly believe that Indian films are kind of stagnating right now. A lot of things are being copied either from the South or from the West. They'll throw the heroine, stripper down, and she'll do some item song with drunk men throwing money on her, and the hero will enter.
One masti number, you mean?
Yeah,
one of those
things. This item song. Indian filmmakers need to do a course in visual effects. This phase is, I think, the worst phase.
You don't really think so?
We have 1.2 billion people here, and we can't make good cinema to entertain everybody. I mean, do we always have to have item numbers?
Totally. You know, you've been an actor in the past. You've been a lead hero. You dabbled in television. You've been assistant director at the age of 16, right? So what made you really want to do direct a film, and that to a film based on, animals, a tiger? That's quite brave to start with.
I've been born in a film house, and storytelling was a part of our family business here. So to actually to evolve into becoming a director is also every actor's dream here, because telling stories is the most fulfilling experience.
Most fascinating experience, I would think. Yeah.
Especially from the journey from vision to visual is a very difficult journey.
Correct. Yeah.
But once completed, it is really overwhelming, when you can actually see the visuals and everything which was in your mind, and to translate that into cinema.
Yeah.
Roar, as my first film, yes, it was the most challenging film to make.
Yeah.
But filmmakers are constantly looking to do something spectacular.
Right.
Looking for a new subject, a new location. And Roar kind of had a combination of everything.
Correct.
It was a genre never made in India.
Also, when you're making a film like this, where lead character is not just not human being, that's wildlife. It's really unpredictable. Doesn't mean that much that you as a director can plan on your, and go by the script, right?
Yeah. To make films like Roar, we had to follow all the steps how films are made in Hollywood.
Right.
We storyboarded every single shot.
Okay.
Is filmed, literally every shot that you see in the film was written and drawn 1 year before this, before we actually filmed it. Then we made a previs. A previs is basically an animated version of the whole sequence.
Okay.
And then we plan how we're going to take various shots here. Wow. So the planning is very, very precise.
But you have to be a wildlife person to actually make a film like that. You're really passionate about wildlife, right?
You have to be passionate about wildlife, but let me tell you, when a lot of people ask me about this tigers, is in our consciousness here, in India. Yeah. Our gods have, astride
tigers.
So India is known as the tiger capital of the world.
Right.
So, it's a part of our consciousness here. And, no one had ever made a film on tigers here. Correct. With us being, our national animal.
There's a film called Ek Tha Tiger.
Of course. And that tiger introduced this tiger.
Yeah, exactly.
We needed a tiger to actually launch our trailer. So we said Salman Khan is the best.
Tiger meets tiger. Totally. Yeah.
Because he has the demeanor of a tiger. His whole structure, his life, the way he's conducted himself is like a tiger.
Yeah. Like, his walk and talk and everything else. Yeah. But how does it feel when someone like a Salman Khan is backing your film?
No, we had great support from Salman. He launched the film. He's been a family friend to me, to Abis Rizvi, the producer. And he was always keen to understand, we used to bump into each other at Mehboob Studio while we were training the actors, doing wire work training, we were doing test shoots. And invariably, we would bump into him because he'd be shooting in Mehboob. Yeah.
Hmm.
So he was very keen to see the process of the way we were making this film. Yeah.
Okay.
Because the kind of special effects we were doing, visual effects, it was very tricky stuff. Yeah.
Hmm.
So he'd been kind of following this film for a long time.
Yeah. All right.
And really when, we got support from two big superstars, actually. One was Jackie Shroff, who actually, we wanted to introduce the Sundarbans with a really deep, solid voice here.
Yeah.
So Jackie, Dada, actually did the voiceover for the trailer.
Awesome.
And then, of course, Salman Bhai came and, we said, let's get a tiger to launch the tiger.
But don't you miss acting somewhere? And you also said that the kind of roles you get offered are like the monkey kind of cinema. I really wanted to elaborate on this. I thought it was very interesting.
I truly believe that Indian films are kind of stagnating right now. Scripts are stagnating. Mm-hmm. I've seen film, in the last couple of years, most of the filmmakers, most of the big stars are working towards getting a big opening.
Correct.
That has become the focus.
That's the target, basically. 3-day weekend opening.
But no one is really emphasizing on a better script, on a better style, on a newer style. A lot of things are being copied either from the South or from the West. And everything, no one is writing anything original, but they're just chasing that 3-day weekend and say, yeah, meri collections itne.
Yeah.
And it's become this big ego battle about
ego
collections.
Trip, absolutely, yeah.
And if you see, the formats have also become very standardized. Yeah. You know, they'll throw the heroine, stripper down, and she'll do some item song with drunk men throwing money on her, and the hero will enter.
One massy there. Number, you mean, one
yeah,
of those
you know,
things,
this
yeah.
item songs. So there's nothing new in cinema. I mean, what are children going to see here? The same rubbish. I mean, how can we bring up our children showing them the same rubbish and making them believe this is cinema?
Totally.
I think, we need to start making better films, better cinema and showing our audience what else can be done.
Yeah. Very interesting. In fact, it just reminds me of something during Ravan. Shah Rukh had said that we don't make different kind of cinema. Forget the fact that a film like Ravan didn't work, but at least it was an effort, an attempt.
Fantastic
correct.
Effort. Yeah.
Exactly. So what he was saying, if we don't make such kind of cinema, there'll be a time that our kids will only look at the West for cinema, only look at the rest of the world for cinema, not Bollywood movies.
Yeah. No. With Roar, what we tried to do was, if you see the film, the edit style, the music, the storytelling style which we use is on an international platform. The visual effects, like a lot of filmmakers always have a complaint saying, we don't have Hollywood budgets, that's why our visual effects are never at par. That's one thing Abbas and I decided on day one. We said, look, we will never come up with an excuse saying that we didn't have the budget or we didn't put the effort. Indian filmmakers need to do a course in visual effects.
Correct.
It's only, you need to have an aptitude when you're going to be dealing with this level of compositing and various work involved there.
If you were to launch yourself today, what would you have done differently?
I definitely do a film with a script.
Okay.
I do a film which has a story, which is not a remake of a South Indian film.
Absolutely.
But there's a lot of confusion with the Hindi filmmakers who now are copying West and South and they're making this mishmash.
Some of the lost in translation.
Yeah, and that cinema is just, it's
too much
garish, it's obscene.
Yeah,
it's,
yeah.
And
So you can't see yourself doing that, right?
I can't
from
see myself doing
gather.
That. In the 90s, films were still, they still had a subtle feel. There was a lot of emphasis on story.
Yeah.
The music was melodic.
The 90s was also kind of over the top in many ways.
It was. Cinema was going, not following any 90s
direction. 90s wasn't the best phase of cinema as such a cinema.
No, it wasn't. I think even 80s wasn't the best phase.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
This phase is, I think, the worst phase.
You really think so? Wow.
I mean, think about, tell me which is in the last 3 years, name 10 films which are memorable or you want to see again. You can name one or two.
Yeah, I know.
But we're talking about
with much
hundreds,
difficulty.
600 films releasing a year. You can't name 10 films in 5 years, which you can say has a shelf value.
Yeah.
Because everyone is chasing that weekend.
Correct, absolutely.
And, it's just big egos and inflated egos and so
the
what
battle
can you do?
For the numbers
and
really.
They have the fans
they are
making the numbers. I mean, it's not it's not like a dream they're chasing. It's
correct. Yeah, of course, the big numbers they're making. Yeah,
but the problem is they're not changing cinema, they're not doing anything towards cinema.
Just a number changes.
Just a number.
every Friday. But tell me, Kamal, you had a huge lull in your career where you weren't in a TV, you were wondering what to do. How do you get over, and you obviously, I mean, I know we're all aware of the tragic past you've had. How do you get over that phase in your life? How do you get out of the darkness and come into light, if I must say?
I was never in darkness.
Really?
So I've never seen life that way.
The tragic incidents in your life didn't really affect you. That's really nice then.
Everyone loses something.
Correct,
everyone can lose, death is inevitable,
absolutely,
right?
Absolutely.
Sometimes it happens prematurely with family members.
Right.
That's what happened with me.
Yeah.
But there was never darkness to a point where I would have, where I'd moan about it or...
Really?
Yeah, I never went through that phase ever in my life.
Kamal, tell me, you're an industry boy, you're a product of Bollywood, you're born into a filmy family. How much support do you get from the film fraternity through your personal crisis, through your career, through you coming back into, mainstream?
Well, that aspect, Bollywood is like a family.
Mm-hmm.
I did get a lot of support through, through my personal tragedies, various lull phases, actors, filmmakers, distributors, friends. Mm-hmm. My entire environment is built into this industry.
Absolutely,
When I say support, let me be clear, no one is going to stop their work or cut their career out to push yours.
Of course.
So if you take that mindset out, yes, then the support is phenomenal.
Yeah.
They will always back you. Like Salman helped us, Jackie helped us. We all from...
Absolutely.
So it's...
there's a kind
of the industry gives you
there.
That support. Our stars are great. Yeah. I mean, as much as adulation they get, and if you see some of our top stars, Shah Rukh, Salman, Hrithik, they're supporting filmmakers, they're supporting new filmmakers, and they're helping them They're launching their trailers. They're getting them
publicity. And it's interesting because we always keep thinking, like, you know, from the outside, you always keep thinking the industry is a very competitive place. There are no friends, you know, and, you know, yet people do come together, right?
But, you know, I don't know what people are looking for in friendship. I mean, if you think he should stop his work or give me money or push me or do my
that
film.
That ain't happening.
That's the wrong way to think. No, everyone has to worry about their own career. Yeah. You can't expect someone to now come and do your film because you want a career boost.
Yeah.
He may help you, he may launch it, he may, you know, talk about it, tweet it, or do something.
But you can't expect that.
Yeah. So, you know, on those lines, the minute people stop, you know, give up their expectations, I think they'll be far much more happier and they'll have many more friends.
Many more friends in the industry, But if you're also friends with Saif Ali Khan, right?
Yeah.
So are you going to, like, ever think of working with him together or directing a film?
No, actually, I haven't even thought of a script with him. But I haven't met him in 2 years.
Oh, really? Okay.
So I really don't know. But I'm in touch with Dingy and the kids.
Yeah. I mean, she also kind of advised you to television at some point, right, Amrita?
Yeah, she did. But Dingy, I meet quite regularly, and of course, Sara and Ibrahim. I've become a lot of the family type guy.
So how is it? Like, how has marriage changed you?
The sheer the commitment of being committed to one person and to be in love and to feel that every morning of your life, and you know, when she's away, there's always this whole excitement of wanting to do something with her, and she actually keeps me on my toes a bit. She's still hard to get. I mean, we're married now 14 years, and she's still hard to get. Really.
Wow.
It's exciting.
She's a makeup artist, right?
Yes.
And she's never done makeup for you.
No.
She's done a makeover in your life,
she's
right?
She's done a makeover, yeah.
More like that.
Yeah. And then with children, of course, you know, it gets into a different zone. And Lisa and I spend a lot of time together, and with the kids.
Yeah.
We travel a lot together with the kids. We don't move around with maids and stuff like that. So
you're a hands-on.
We're very hands-on on that.
No, you said you don't know any world but the world of cinema.
Yeah.
So do we see you making more films? Do we see you directing more films?
Yes.
And do we see you in front of the camera?
I don't know when in front of the camera. I don't know how life will take.
Like his goodbye to acting.
Yeah, but
is it that bad?
No, it's not that bad. I'm just enjoying making films a lot.
Okay.
It's really fulfilling. It's tiring. It has a lot of effort, but it is really absolutely fulfilling. And Abbas and I have actually planned another film. We're hoping Roar is accepted well by the audience, because that kind of eases the journey for the next film. Because the next film. If you think Roar was challenging,
another adventure film.
It's another action adventure where Roar would look like a walk in the park.
Oh really?
Yeah, it's a very, very tricky film to make.
Okay.
It's not with animals, but it's the same genre as action adventure.
So you're going to stick to like non-Bollywood stars. Kind of
I don't know about the casting. Our script is not yet complete, but it is widescreen cinema. It is big actions, big visual.
Okay.
That's the kind of cinema I grew up seeing. You know, I grew up
seeing. That's your vision for cinema.
Yeah,
I
saw Star Wars when I was a kid. I saw Indiana Jones, and I was like, wow, look at these films. Yeah.
Right.
You know, the sheer scale, the grandness of these films, and those are the kind of films I want to make. Yeah. Yeah. And you know, why is anyone making these films in India?
Correct,
You know, why do we always have to go west to see it? We have 1.2 billion people here. And we can't make good cinema to entertain everybody. I mean, do we always have to have item numbers?
Totally. But tell me, is there any cinema in recent times that you've seen and you wish you were a part of?
You know, I really like Rajkumar Hirani's films.
Yeah.
I like his storytelling style.
Absolutely. Yeah.
I like Sanjay Leela Bansali's storytelling style.
Yeah.
He's got a finesse which is quite spectacular. I like Rajkumar Santoshi's quirky, sense of humor which he has, which is, I find it extremely entertaining. So, these are the three filmmakers I follow quite closely.
Is there any actor you'd like to direct?
Yes. I like Ranveer Singh. Ranveer Singh and I like Ranbir Kapoor.
Yeah.
I think these two boys are, and Siddharth Malhotra.
Okay.
I think these youngsters are fantastic. I mean, their screen presence, their entire demeanor, they're very bright and they hold your attention.
Yeah.
A lot of energy.
Yeah.
And Ranbir Kapoor is a brilliant actor.
Absolutely.
Ranbir and Siddharth are still growing into good actors.
Yeah.
So yes, amongst the youngsters, these boys, I'd definitely like to work with these boys if I get an opportunity to.
Yeah. And do you still keep getting monkey kind of cinema offers every day?
No, they've stopped.
You really the stuff now?
Yeah, you know,
I mean, so badly.
I made so many statements in the press, you know, saying that
they don't come to you at all.
Yeah, because I said every time, you know, Indian filmmakers would see a tree, they would be like, you know, dance around this. I mean, get over it, you know.
That is really funny.
You see a tree, that doesn't mean you have to dance around it. Yeah.
So you don't acts? I mean, you don't listen to any scripts anymore?
No, I don't. I've been interested in filmmaking, and I think it's quite evident amongst the well, at least in the industry, yeah, that I've, yeah, you know, this is my profession.
Right.
This is the career I choose, I've, yeah, opted for as a filmmaker. What I'm always in the lookout for are good scripts. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But good scripts, you know, I keep meeting a lot of script writers who come and say, sir, this is a brilliant script, and I realize it's a mishmash of some Hollywood film without them even knowing that I've seen all the films. I've seen it all, so don't lie to me. Oh, you know, they mishmash all these films together, yeah, and they come and give it to you. And now they're mishmashing Korean films and French films.
So now fewer scripts will come to you after this interview, because I'm not going to do that again.
I hope there are fewer scripts who will come.
At least original ones will come to you, yeah, let's hope.
Because even script writers are wary of what to write, yeah, because, yeah, look at what our big stars are doing.
Yeah. Right, yeah.
Really,
you don't really know what works, because the kind of cinema you believe in might not really work at the box office.
No, see, given cinema, the kind of cinema that's a lot working of elements. You know, if you're talking commercial cinema, it must be well, the screenplay must be good, the pace has to be good, there has to be an entertainment quotient, the characterization has to be great.
Yeah.
So,
but Kamal, we've seen movies without any of these things you mentioned, which have done really well.
That's because on sheer star power, no?
Exactly.
Because their fan following is so strong.
So I guess that leaves scriptwriters and writers in general confused as to what really works. They're trying their best to put everything together, all elements together.
Yeah, because,
right?
I mean, they feel the superstars are only going to do these kind of films.
Exactly,
so,
yeah,
you know, let's write these. See, the superstars can do any film, yeah, and it'll work.
Right.
Screenwriters need to start
writing
better.
That's how audiences, star worshippers. Yeah,
yeah, but if they can't get the superstar, they need to start writing good scripts.
Correct, yeah.
Because the superstars will only do one film a year, and there are just five of them. So you, yeah, take those five films out of the equation,
yeah,
then you have...
So either you have a very big star or you have a very good script, right? Yeah. That's what really works.
It's two things. Big star or a big great script.
Good, yeah, one, we've cracked it. It was great talking to you, Kamal. I really hope your film rose at the box office. Wish you all the best.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Nice to be on the show.